Hello all, it's Jim Johnson, aka Sulfur Blade, and welcome back to War on the Sea and my specific campaign mod playthrough. So, where are we right now? We have the Allied Command, the Brits and the Aussies, making their way up with Invasion Force Australia to Sarong, accompanied by the Darwin Task Force. We've got Task Force Exeter currently patrolling off Milne, kind of loitering and wasting time, if you will, there, just in case an emergency happens in this area. Seems like an okay place to loiter in. Just if an emergency were to happen here, they can respond or help out. We have the shuttle, which is just two little ships that broke off from the invasion force, Australian invasion force, and they're currently bringing some troops from Tarawa up to Port Moresby. Midway Island, I'm pretty sure, is about as empty as you can get right now. Most all of the ships are heading away from Midway, not much is heading to it. So, for timing to be empty, I guess it works out. Amphib Group 1 is heading over to Tarawa to maybe pick up some more troops to bring in to Kazre, as Kazre seems to be, it doesn't look like it's going to be a complete walk in the park there. And yeah, that pretty much sums up where we're at. So let's go ahead and start the clock. Wasp has put up air over. Okay. All right, and CTF-1 is currently making her way to rendezvous with Task Force Pensacola in order to make a run on Rabaul. It's probably going to be the biggest mission of the episode. We are going in to Sarong in broad daylight. Slow traveling, risking a response from a level 5 airfield, a level 2 airfield, or a level 3 airfield, excuse me. Feel like Darwin probably needs to get a bit closer. Might be too close. The timing on this maneuver is probably not smart on my behalf. certainly don't drive up to the edge and sit there and wait to be bombarded. Can we unload from here? Didn't think so. Oh no, there goes our air cover. All right. Emergency air cover. Invasion Force Australia. 13 Dauntlesses. Flying cap. Food. Num num. New air. Bow fighters. Rockets. Done. Course. There. To there. Good. Ignore. Continue on. Alright, managed to unload. Now, let's get out of Dodge, shall we, please? How's Sarong doing? Not bad. Amban should be under complete control soon enough. Fighters have found their food. Let's go ahead and form them up into box. 256, 257-ish. 390. Right over there. Target two first. Speed up. Lost a bow fighter on that run. That's the vanilla cargo ship, isn't it? Critical. Okay, they're both down. Time to get out of Dodge. Go ahead and RTB. I'm going to get a little more focused on here as I'm expecting a retaliation shortly. That's not what I want. Don't want the fighters to be leaving at this point in time. How much endurance do these Dauntlesses have? Plenty. Interesting. I'll mark that. Starting to see a pattern of shipping there. Heading where? Yeah, I think that's probably the logical location. It just doesn't seem to be right. A box in here might be bad for a surface action group to patrol. Anyway, is that carrier range? Yes. Why not? Yorktown, you get the honors. Launch aircraft. Avengers with normal rockets, please. Whole flight group? Yeah. Should find it. Go ahead and ignore. Okay. Or food. Go ahead and ignore that one. There's nothing over the invasion force right now. Certainly we must be getting darn close here. Nine through sixteen. Form up box. 1 through 8. Form up box. Through 16, go ahead and target 1, attack, and 1 through 8, target 2, attack. How dangerous of a group are we looking at? Non-vanilla cargo. Non-vanilla tanker. Okay, so about as least dangerous as it gets. Nine completely missed. Alright, entire group. Form up into one box. Two is down. One and two are down. Okay, nice successful strike on food. It was fun to see the Avengers in action. Go ahead and RTB. I'm gonna mark this guy. It's getting fairly close to the carrier. Is it close enough to drag the carrier in? I don't think so, but probably to be better on the safe side. Small cap of 12 wildcats over CTF1. It's done. All right, Darwin, you need a course. Head this way, loiter back a little. Head this way, loiter back a little. Head this way, loiter back a little. This way, loiter back a little. This way. Flying fish going back for torps. Haddock heading in to patrol this heavy shipping area here. It's evening. All right, Darwin. 12. Over Invasion Force Australia. Good. Pensacola. 5 to 6 to 7 to 8 to 9 to 10. 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 15 hours, I want to approach the circle. Alright, that should be good timing. Now, what am I going to do with the carrier? That's about what the carrier is going to do. We've got something at Tarawa. Amphib group 1. You came down here to grab possible troops, right? Yeah. Manage cargo. Not a lot of troops here. We'll throw supplies onto the Macaulay. I don't really want to take anything else from here. Is that really worth putting the ships in danger to come back with? Yes. Is it? Is it really? Probably isn't. Kazri does need a little help, I think. How long is this going to take, Tarawa? Or the amphib group? 37. The carrier might be able to get back in time to provide some cover. Let's just do it. You know what? What time? Pensacola's arriving. Right. Seven o'clock. So 8 o'clock around the edge of the circle. 9, 10, 11, 12. About midnight at Rabaul. Task Force Exeter. It is about 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. So 13 hours till grounding. 14 would rather be where I would be approaching the circle from. So 14 at the edge of the circle. Let's take a slightly more direct course. Too direct. American and Allied forces have been dispatched to bombard Rabaul in conjunction with each other. Food. Carrier's actually closer, but do I want them to really do the eating of the food at this point? No. I'd rather have Milne do it. Bowfighters. Rockets. Done. Course. Straight there. Ignore. I'm going to utilize the flight decks on the carriers as little as possible. actually Milne. Kitty Hawks. Go ahead and escort Task Force Exeter. Bowfighters see nothing. We're gonna go to tactical anyway. Gotta be something in this area. Yep. Warm up box 250 7 390. Vanilla tanker. To impatiently make the strafe on number one while she's lined up perfectly. Good. should do her. Food is down. Retreat, leave, confirm. RTB. NAP troops defeated at Amban. Good news. Excuse me. Invasion force. Change your course. I'm gonna go pick up some dudes. Darwin? Head over here. Lighter like so. All right, time to get a group up over the Pensacola. Yorktown, launch air, 18 Wildcats, done. Over Task Force Pensacola. That flight group is actually the former flight group from the Enterprise. They were transferred onto the Yorktown when she came in theater. Alright, Rabaul's chasing its tail in the usual locations it chases its tail, so hopefully we're gonna catch Rabaul unawares. think we might have a haddock. Alright, haddock, that's your patrol box. To Midway. Alright, Wake does have plenty of supplies, engineering, and fuel, and there'll still be a hefty remainder left over, so we're gonna go ahead and do level 2. Alright, that's gonna allow us to get a bit more activity going on. One wildcat. About like so. Like so. Well, like so. Wake Island, New Air, One Flying Fortress, empty, done. Gonna fly a perimeter around Wake. Sure. we have Catalina's now too. Much more eyes in and around Wake. Interesting. Food. New air. Bow fighters. Rockets. Done. Course. Something like so, ignore. Thank you. them up. Speed up. They're down. More food consumed. RTB. Coming up to 6:30. Perfect distance from Rabaul. Good timing on this run. Oh, really? Oh, no. We really have nothing up over the Exeter. I thought we had good timing going on. Anything up in the air here? One Dauntless. Where are you? Nowhere near. Speed up. Head to the task force and feel free to dogfight. These are probably Emily's too. This isn't gonna be good. Mid-range bombers. Holy fuck. Nepal? Break. Speed up. Charge that mass. Nizam, break, speed up. Charge that mass. Canberra, actually slow down to let your escort get around you. Van Gelen, brake, charge the craziness. I told you to speed up, didn't I? Don't worry about evading. Just do what I'm telling you. Alright, speed the fleet up. Rudder amidships. Brake, hard over, Gambia, brake, straight ahead, I told you to brake, didn't I? Flak is actually doing a job. Van Gelen, they look like they're after you. How strange. Not. Or actually they are. Here comes the bombs. Woo! Did you get hit? You did. All back. Canberra, bring the whatever's actually in formation with you that way. What are these? Torpedo bombers. The destroyer picket's working. Uh-oh. You are already backing down. Took one in the kisser. Norman? What are these? Are these bombers? These are bombers. Paul struck by a torpedo? Thought that already happened. What are amidships, please? Brake all back so you don't run into the Exeter. Exeter, shit. All right, now Norman, all forward. Exeter, stable your rudder. Forward, please. Slow. Canberra, all back. Oh, Australia. Slow down. Come over. Stable out. Just come to a stop. Nepal. Come to a stop. You don't look so hot. No, you really don't look so hot. On a fire, please. How about the new fire? A newish fire, anyway. Van Gallen, you got hit too. Don't do a stop. Azam, you're fine. Let's go ahead and come to a stop. Canberra, you too can come to a stop. Exeter, like everybody else, stop. Norman, stop. Stopping. Gambia. Stop. You did well. All right. Fleet is halting. Nepal, I think, is the one worst off right now. I would actually rather you be... No, the... I'd rather you on that fire, but if I can't get you there, fine. Please get you, yeah, that's where I want you. I would like to confine the damage forward and not have it spread. That could have went a lot worse. The destroyers did an excellent job blowing away those torpedo planes as they were inbound. Nepal did an excellent job taking one in the kisser. We'll have to reward the commander for its valiant effort to actually protect a capital ship via putting its own ship in danger. Well, it looks like Task Force Exeter is going to be heading back to Midway for repairs. Most of the capital ships... Well, Gambia's a light cruiser. Gambia's fine. Capital ship Australia, fine. Capital ship Canberra, fine. Capital ship Exeter took a little beating. Maybe lost some ammo. Escort Norman, okay. Escort Nepal took some beating. Escort Van Gelen took a beating. So two escorts and... I don't want to say minor, but... Yeah, moderate's probably the perfect way to go. So moderate damage to the Exeter herself and two escorts that'll need repair. All in all, it could have gone a lot worse than that. You know what? Hornet. Launch aircraft. Wildcats. 18. Done. Course. That way. Yorktown, launch, all your wildcats, course, that way. I'm manually telling them to go places because it's after 7 o'clock. I think we're pretty safe at this point. You know what? CTF1. Make your course like so. Exeter, you can start off. Get home. Okay, Pensacola, it's about to be your turn. Rolls down to a 2-2. Rolls pretty goddamn tanky, isn't it? Now for the escape. oddly, that's going to work out with the Exeter. Granted, we don't want to have to waste some time repairing some of her task force, but her being back in at Midway is just going to allow us to beef her up and make her a bit stronger. So, we can look at the silver lining in it. She'll get to go back to Midway so that she can get some additional firepower. I believe she's 8 ships right now. Yeah, and with her, we might actually go and spend some money on one of those British battleships. Why? Because I think it makes sense in that naval doctrine for the Allies might have been more surface-oriented than the U.S. Navy was in the Pacific Theater. Well, the U.S. Navy was very carrier-oriented because that was what they had to be. The majority of the surface force was caught in Pearl Harbor. And it just happened to be that the carriers were out to sea doing exercises at the time. So it was really the carriers that had to really develop a carrier doctrine in the Pacific. Whether or not the U.S. wanted a carrier doctrine or not, it was left with one. Gonna try to really tightly knit pack in these units that we're all going about. Actually, the carrier needs to come back over here this way and do some escort duties on Amphib Group 1. Right after she successfully escorts these task forces away from Rabaul. Alright, Yorktown. Oh, yeah, I'm not trying to bombard, I'm trying to launch aircraft. 18. Done. Over. Task force. Pensacola. I'm hoping the same cap can serve to escort all the groups. That's why I'm trying to box them up so tightly. Interesting, we found food. Well, that's for Milne. The rockets. Done, course. I'm going to send them straight at it, because I'm not sure where that food's going, if I have to be frank. It could be food heading up this way. Seems like it is going off in this direction. Yeah. Right, so bow fighters. Go to that, fly a course like that, and you should come across them. Loiter. No, better to be safe than sorry. Let the carrier catch up. No reason to send those guys into a location without any cover. All right. Manage cargo. What Ambon was one. It looks one. Why is there a fire? Alright, that'll be the garrison for now. We really doing that? I guess we are. Darwin, put up done over invasion force Australia. Thank you. Bow fighters, tactical. Food to eat. Warm up box. I wonder. Vanilla. Actually, this is a fairly, what's the word I'm looking for? Docile task force. We're gonna do something different. Warm up. Line ahead. Thank you. lined up so nicely for us, since we just happened to spawn in right in front of them. Let's go right down their throat. Target one. Target two, everyone, attack. What the hell? Everyone, target two, attack. Form up, drop down. One's down. Status on two. Two's critical. Okay. Two's down. We're out of here. TV. Dauntless is somewhere. Okay. Not quite out of the woods yet, guys. Not out of the woods yet. But I do feel happy about Rabaul being knocked down to a level 2 airfield. I'm already feeling like this area of the world has gotten a lot more secure. In that our air power is going to be harassed a hell of a lot less. So, one already gets the sneaking suspicion that Rabaul has a lot of forces, if it, without being told that such is the case by overzealous people who watch the program. Not to say I wouldn't assume that Rabaul has a lot of forces, but people have made the have told me that I'll need at least 20,000 troops to take Rabaul because of the huge size of the garrison. And I think the huge size of the garrison is part of the reason that we're having such a hard time actually bombarding the facilities here. If this was any one of these other places we've bombarded, it would have been knocked down to nothing at this point. But because there is such a large garrison there, and the garrison actually absorbs a lot of the bombardments, it's in a way protecting the facilities that are here at Rabaul, the huge garrison that they have there. In fact, I've heard Truck is so bad that you can bombard it and not even scratch it. It'll just stay a 5-5. And that has made people believe that Truck is invincible. But I don't believe Truck is invincible. I believe what's going on at Truck when people are bombarding it is that the garrison is so huge that you need to be able to overcome the garrison. The garrison strength. You need to bring the garrison strength down so far that it's not tanking for the facilities and basically making the facilities invulnerable. So in this mod, when you bombard stuff, you're doing 10% damage to the garrison. So 10% of the garrison is being killed. So if there's 50,000 troops there, 10% of 50,000 is what? 5,000? Yeah. So you're killing off 5,000 troops and leaving 45,000 troops in the place after you hit it. So if Rabaul had, say, 20,000 troops there, each of them, those bombardments that I just did would have been 10%, 10%, 10%, 10%, 10%, 10%. But you got to remember that 10% is not 10% of the original. It's 10% of what is left. So 10% of 19,000 is less than 10% of 20,000. And so the smaller you make it, the less the 10% takes off. I think you guys get the concept. Anyway, it looks like we have some air coming up on us. So let's go to Well, I know Pensacola has 18 over her. And I know we have a group of 6 Wildcats flying constant patrol duty. That'll probably get pulled in. 6 and 18 is what, 24? Is 24 Wildcats enough to not risk screwing up our flight decks? Or should we I think we can toss up more. Yorktown. Launch, 19, done, and we'll technically put them over Exeter, sure, but they should take part in this battle. feel pretty confident about our safety at this point. That's interesting. Not exactly what I was expecting to see. Not at all what I was expecting to see. I think we got an escort carrier, a Japanese escort carrier in the neighborhood. Those weren't land-based planes. I don't think they are. Very interesting, nonetheless. Okay. I believe we have enough cover up right now. Zeros. Lost a wildcat. No. All right, the small number of zeros we're seeing here, I think these are coming from Rabaul. Where's this?
Interesting.
Through five down. Wildcats don't seem to be interested in anything else. Carrier can hit something like that. Amphib group one is heading in. Carrier, make a beeline up there. I'm pretty sure the task forces are safe to escape now. Wait.
What's sitting here? Shuttle. Shuttle is returning with some troops. Yeah. What am I going to do with the shuttle right now? I don't know. I mean, the USNS fleets are going to be more than capable of emptying Midway. One and two will haul off the engineering and fuel, leaving three to deal with troops and supplies. Those troops and supplies will end up going to Tarawa. The shuttle could probably go and grab some of that from Tarawa, I suppose. Tarawa should have receive that by the time it gets there. Pause. Unload all. Sarong should be under control sooner than later. Invasion force Australia. Set your course down yonder. So I'm going to retest the shuttle. Am I going to retest the shuttle? No. No, it's fine. Yeah, I am. For now, you can just head there. What I'm going to plan to do is take the troops from Sarong back to Amban. Amban is going to kind of be the headquarters of this area, so it's where I'm going to want the largest garrison. Not going to want them all sitting in Sarong. Just have that many troops there now to, win the battle. But I'll eventually want those guys transferred back to Amban. So major dumps. First major dump, Tarawa. Second major dump, Moresby. Then Amban. Those will be the major dumps that'll serve as kind of our supply chain. Right, Tarawa, what is this USNS fleet doing here? Delivering some odds and ends, troops and supplies. I think we can start making direct routes now that we have Wake under control. There any point attempting? Yeah, we're close enough. So, not Wasp. Well, actually, we're gonna want cover up here as well. So, launch aircraft. 13, done. You're going over Invasion Force Australia. And then Yorktown. You're going to launch 18. And you're going to fly cover over. That should be Amphib Group 1, right? All right, so we have air cover over the things that are going to need air cover. Other than that, this is probably where we're going to wrap up this episode. We are sitting up to 83 command points. I'm going to start saving up because, well, we're going to beef up Task Force Exer after she finishes repairing. And we're also going to want to start saving up for some of those July Bogues. The Bogue class escort carrier is going to unlock sooner than later, and that's going to give us a lot of fun. I'm thinking I might throw a Bogue in each of our USNS fleets. It won't really slow them down because the Bogues are what, 24 knots or 18 knots? Either way, they're as fast as these merchant ships. So that'll keep the USNS fleets from possibly being jumped by carriers, because the Bogue should be able to launch enough fighter cover to at least put up a fight. Or that's the thought. And that's really kind of the main purpose for the Bogue, was to escort merchants, right? That's why it was called an escort carrier. So yeah, USNS Fleet 1, 2, and 3 will all get a Bogue. Amphib Group 1 might get a bogue as well, might get two bogues. Maybe a bogue and another C3S. Yeah, So a fourth bogue. And then I'm going to need a fifth bogue over here to join with the Darwin. I want the Darwin to have extra capacity plane-wise for dealing with some of this stuff over here. So that's five bogues already spoken for. How many bogues do we get? Next question. U.S. CV, actually. CVLs. Oh, quite a few. 30 July. Of course, it's the end of July. But it's good to know that there will be... will they all be instantly available? If they are, we got more than enough bogues to go around. More than enough indeed. I might toss two in with the Wasp. Will they fit? Can the Darwin Task Force hold one, two? Yeah, she can easily hold two additional bogues to escort her. And we could throw in... What else would we throw in with that? Maybe another light cruiser? Another one of these Crown Colony classes? And maybe a fifth destroyer? Or maybe one of those old light cruisers, the Adelaide class. So get, yeah, an Adelaide plus a Crown Colony in here, plus two bogues. Anyway, those are kind of future musings. This is where we are currently in the campaign. Not doing too bad, I don't think. I think we're making pretty good progress at occupying the map. Knocking down Rabaul. I feel like we can comfortably take Shortland next after Cosray Falls. As we have knocked kind of the air capacity here that made invading Shortland a much scarier prospect. It'll still be a prospect that we'll need air cover for, because there's more than enough planes that can come from these locations that could do a hell of a lot of walloping to an undefended invasion force. But what I'm thinking is that CTF-1 can easily escort that now. Escorting in a merchant fleet with CTF-1 when Rabaul was at full capacity, that was a kind of a different situation, right? Rabaul plus the other place could throw up like 72 aircraft, which could have easily overrun the escort that we'd put up over. But now I think we're fine. And that's the last musings I'm going to do. This has been another episode of my War in the Pacific mod playthrough in War of the Sea. Hopefully you're enjoying it. If so, please smash that like button, consider subscribing, and until next time, all, peace.